Okay, so hi everyone. Thank you so much for joining us today. We are Team Little Box and we have our CEO Rimjhim Dekha. And today we also have with us six inspiring self-made women. And we are glad you could make it for high tea and join us for a conversation. So we have Tina, who is a DJ and an event organizer. And we have Ipshita, who is a singer by profession. We have Baker Farnaz. We have the CEO of Sri Silk, Bhavna Kalita. We have Alia Barua, who is a very renowned RJ of Big FM. So first, we would like to give each one of you a small bouquet as a token of appreciation.
Professionally, I came into scene in 2006 as a TV host to the first satellite channel of Northeast, that was NETV. So I have done all the shows in all the bands. Generally what happened, every RJ has a particular band, you know, morning band, afternoon band and the evening band. So I am the one who had all the shows in all the bands, because first I was in Radio Ulala. And then in 2010, I joined 92.7 Big FM. So from 2010 till today, I'm still with Big. And I was doing all kind of shows, you know, morning, evening, afternoon band. And basically, Northeast, I'm the one who has taken a lot of Bollywood interviews. I couldn't leave my own state because I got offers from outside, but I don't know why I'm not able to leave Assam. Yeah, so that's why I'm here. And Big is one station which has given me a lot of opportunities. And then again, you are the voice of the station. And somehow I'm a little more more honest to someone when it's like, you're the voice of the station. So it's been a voice of the station from so many years. But now I don't use it. Yeah, but it's RJ Alia who is always Chalia.
Before Sri Silk, I was in an engineering college.
Okay.
So I did my engineering, and after my engineering, but during college also, I was actively, I was an active member of the fashion club. So I represented college.
Which college?
RB College of Engineering, Bangalore.
Okay.
Rashtriya Vidyalaya. Okay. Yeah. So we went to Goa to represent our college. We went to Delhi and went to the local colleges within Bangalore. Then after engineering, I was still confused, but I was passionate about fashion since I was a kid. So I used to have those magazines, Vogue, Grazia, Cosmo, and see the, I would not be interested in anything else but those colorful pages of clothes, you know, bags, clothes, shoes, they print.
Oh,
yeah. So then after that, somehow my parents supported me also. So they're like, you can think of handloom if you wish to, change. So I was simultaneously preparing for GMAT also, but Sri Silk was growing. I started with one machine. And now we have 3 units.
You have 3 factories?
3 factories, yeah.
Amazing. How many weavers?
So we have 11 per factory, but sometimes every machine is not occupied.
Yes.
Yeah, so right now total of 25 weavers we have.
25 weavers.
Yes, yeah.
And they are permanently working with you?
Permanently, yeah. Most of them are working with me since 5 years, 4 years. Yeah.
Amazing.
So that's how it started, and after it started getting commercial, I did not think of doing anything else. I was like, let me just focus on this. Still, I want to make it big. Right now, it's slowly, people are getting to know within Assam. I want to take it all across India. We are mostly into bridal. And the sales have also increased by 3 times, 4 times.
Year on year?
Yeah.
Wow.
Every year. So, yeah. So that's how I have 3 units, because the production has to, the consumer demand has to, supply and consumer has to go hand in hand. I also single-handedly look after the designing part.
Only founder? You're the only founder?
Yeah, my mom is there. She's just to support.
Support.
Yeah. We know about Kanchipuram sarees. We know about Banarasi silk.
Yeah.
We know about Lucknow chicken curry. Then why don't the people know about Mekhla Sarar? Yeah. But through the power of social media, it's becoming better. you know, people are getting to know about it. So, you know, there are challenges because when I go for exhibitions outside, you know, Mekhela Sador, which is like a premium product, why would people want to buy it? So, but then, you know, it's always fun convincing them. Most of them ultimately end up like, you know, buying it because it's so beautiful. Once you drape it, it looks different.
And it's easy.
To- it's easy. Uh-huh. Yeah.
It's easy to wear.
It's very easy to wear.
Very easy to wear.
And comfortable to move around also.
Whenever I go to Asa, I never carry sari because I need someone who will help. Because most of the time, I'm ulta type, you know, sari.
Or slippery feel with a pinner.
Right. I can do anything.
Tell us something about your brand. Something about yourself. What motivated you?
Actually, the thing is that it was not me, the one you know, who has started this business. It was me and my sister. We both were there. Firstly, she started back in 2017. Then she learned from my dad. Actually, he used to bake cakes during Eid and Ramzan. So she, you know, she wanted to make, and then she learned from him. We had to carry tiffins. To, you know, eat the cakes to bring back, and then we got to know that the taste isn't like the one that we made. So, matlab allaman difference asile. Yeah, yeah, quality was not the one. Matlab allaman difference asile. So, again we did this basic class again. So, titya rakko mane taste to gompalu, keneka hoy gompalu. Luckily, my sister got married, and I am the only one handling everything. So right now it's been 7 years, so I'm doing it. It's just like my passion ki moi kori bhal pai aso, mane because I am not the one like who you know, jito already mane kitab likha ase to porhi mukhasto karim. I don't like this. I love creativity. Yeah, matlab jot ami nijor brain use karibo paru, jot ami mane nijor ideas put karibo paru, so that's what I like. Mane that's the reason I have actually, you know, passed BLLB, and I am a lawyer right now. But I also did practicing, but that didn't make me wanna. So again, back to baker life. So I love that.
So kotha jodi moi kobo jao ganor logot tumi bahut full pray involved asilu. I think my school joar agote moi gan hikisilu. And I'm a classical singer, I'm classically trained. So, and since I'm in Guwahati, so there were never a shortage of functions or, you know, programs that I, you know, could not attend. I used to join everything. If I knew ki kobat kiba hoise, I would be a part of that. And I used to love being part of, you know, social gatherings and events. And, you know, music always went on, but, you know, side by side along with my academics. Aru schoolot, yes, I used to sing in school, then college, my university at 5 years post graduation and post graduation. I was the best singer in Western vocals 2 times in a row. So teneke thakile, in fact college ot thakute, any because I used to since gana sile logot, so it helped me also earn my pocket money. Karan, you know, shows. This is in school itself, and Urban Mantra came up. Hekini homoyote, they used to, you know, have those gigs, live music. So I started, you know, from college days itself. I started to know the profession of it, and the thing is that I am always, you know, I always believe in doing a lot of things at the same time. So I never left my academics, and as such, I did my MCom and MBA, and I'm a financial analyst by profession. I was working with a lot of companies. I have worked in Pune, I've worked in Bombay, Guwahati as well, Karbi Anglong. But music is something that is very close to my heart. It is one thing that I cannot live without. It has given me a purpose, has given me a name. So I came up with my debut singles, music videos. I started exploring.
When was your first album launch?
It was in 2017. It was in 17, right after my first master's got over. I thought ki thik ase eti alavman ganot lagu, and at the same time I was also working with Amazon Pune, so ganor logote I was staying there. So, you know, something always called me back home because I knew ki when I'm staying outside, I have to take a call. Like, you know, how much will you be able to give yourself in a job and then, you know, in your passion. So I tried to carry to
together as much as I can. But I think eventually I took a call. I think 3.5 years later, I came back to Guwahati. And then yate, I have been working here from here as well. I work for a few corporates from Guwahati itself. And I think 2022, I left my job. Finally, I thought, you know, I want to explore more. I have also started to write. I have been working on directing. I have written my scripts. And I think, I believe we are always in a self-discovery mode. I think we should not stop, you know? The more you think about yourself, the more you realize that there is so much to do. So I think I'm a work in progress. Even though I'm doing music, I'm financial analyst, the thing is also going on. But I think I'm yet to figure out who really I am.
I think, like, from corporate,
yeah,
we all have shifted from the corporate world to something towards our passion, yes, trying to, you know, find our own journey.
True.
So yeah, but eventually I think that's what makes life, the journey.
True.
Itself
the
makes
journey
life
itself.
Not the goal.
Yeah,
the end goal is like, we'll just see, but the journey itself.
Yeah. I don't think I want to be one-dimensional, you know. I want to be multidimensional. I want to know what else lies out there that we can do about. And I think we live in an age where everything can be capitalized. And I think nothing is wrong with that. I mean, Guwahati is a, you know, is a booming place.
It's
it's the gateway to the Southeast Asia. Imagine the potential this place has. I don't think, you know, I would say that Guwahati is not saturated, is what I mean.
Yeah.
So I think there's a lot to explore in this place, and why not be here and explore your horizons?
That's really nice. And next time you launch your next album, do let us know.
Yes, and not just the album. I think it's too early to say this, but I'm working with on a venture.
Okay.
So I'm hoping that you guys will be hearing about it soon, and when it happens, you all will be there.
We're excited about it. Wow, we are excited about it now. How many tattoos do you have?
Psychologically.
Sort of. I have six tattoos. But yeah, this is one, two. And then there's one here. There's one here somewhere. This is one. There's one at the back. But it look, I wanted to make a firefly, but it turned into a mosquito. So we did not realize we had to make a 3D tattoo. So yeah, make it look like a... Yeah.
No regrets.
Yeah. Okay, so I look after, I do a few other stuff, like multiple things I do. I look after the programming for events at Greenwood Resort. I have a social media marketing firm called Quintessential Media.
Okay.
I have few clients, very new. It's been 1 year that I have like six clients, I think. And then I actually freelance for a music festival as stage manager and artist manager. So
quite a lot on your plate.
And then I DJ, which is a hobby. Not like I do it full time, but it's a hobby. Yeah, I don't like playing in weddings because people try to come and tell me what to play. And then they keep requesting, which I don't like. So yeah, I like playing what I like playing.
Yeah.
So not like I am not accommodative, but it is more like I enjoy hearing.
What made you think that you wanted to become a baker?
No, see, I am somebody who always have, like, helped my mother in the kitchen. I am, yeah, like, I mane mas basibo hikisu jetia 7 bochor asil. Like koru mas type, in a way, that is something I think. So yeah, I would always like assist my mother with everything. She used to love making dosa. So every summer we used to have a week that everybody is only having dosa and idli at home because that was prepared. Town planning officer, which I never turned into.
That's
so
interesting.
Yeah.
Specific also, very specific.
Yeah.
Very,
yeah.
Town planning.
Who puts that as a town planning? Town planning and all of that.
In the first unit, when I was, that is what my father has planned what she's going to be.
Right.
So that is what I was telling everybody today. Then please don't tell us.
Yeah.
What do we want to do? What
yeah,
we have
please,
to do?
Please let us decide what I wanted to be, you know?
Let us explore.
And because I'm just trying to inspire her, no, you're trying to be imposing.
Right,
yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Right, most cosy. Right.
Till today, even that day when I receive an award, I told my father, see, I receive an award. congratulations. But you know what? APSC, you can still
apply. that has been there. Yeah, yeah, everybody. So basically, Delhi golu, geography honors porilu. First year of college, I was given some certain amount of money ki manot sunibo laibo type, right? So I was like, oh, I need more money now. How to earn more money? So I called people. Then I realized ki if you are not interning anywhere, you don't get a job. So
your internship was a very prominent one, yeah. I remember. So, right? It's very, sobe jane, or that's a very...
So when I was looking for jobs at that point, and then a friend of mine actually helped. He said, oh, there's a company called OML who does NH7 Weekender. So they are looking for interns, and it's an all girls intern, like group. 16 girls they wanted to hire in Delhi. And they were taking interview. So I was given a number, I called that guy up and I was like, is there a job? He's like, there's no job, but there's internship, which is for free. Then I said, oh, what am I getting in return? He said, every day pick up and drop you'll get, and you'll get food of whatever you like. So I said, do you think you'll give me butter chicken every day? So they gave me butter chicken every day for 2 years. Because of OML, I got to work for NH7. There was a music festival called EDC India, which I worked for. And their on-ground marketing, also like artist management part. Infected Mushrooms, there's a band, they were performing. And I'm there at the event till 3 o'clock at night. And then so I went home, I dozed off. I woke up at like 6 in the morning revising. And then I went off to sleep and woke up at 10. So they didn't let me give their exam. I ran back to the college. I could not. They were like, oh, you can't. So next, I have to wait for one year to give that. And I was like, it to hobo in work. It kenake hobo, no. But then DU had a rule that if 2 semesters, you get overall 40%, then you're a graduate. Right, so I decided nidu.
Because of that.
Yeah, I was like, anyway, second division hai fam, ki hobo, no. I did not give.
So today we'll be playing Pass the Canvas. Okay, and we have divided the team into threes. So here we have Rimjim, Tina and Shita. And on team two, we have RJ Alia, we have Bhavna and we have Farnaz. So the game is such that the first person has to paint something as per their free will, and you cannot discuss with your teammates. So once you have drawn something, you just pass it on to your teammate, and your teammate will add something else, and the third person will finish it off. So we'll just see what's the combination of three of you, how it comes out. So shall we start? Yeah, okay. All of you won today because you all made it today on like and made it a very memorable high tea event, and we have a special gift hamper from Little Box for all of you.